Africa is the land of my ancestors. My name is Simon Ssenkaayi, a Ugandan and African who believes that the world has a place for us too. My mentor told me that whatever I avoid, I can never criticize. He reminds me every day that the time to let things happen has passed. It is now a time to make things happen. In Southern Sudan, my brother nation in the north, over 1,000 people have lost their lives, and most of them are not soldiers, but women and children. Someone might ask, why are they dying? Because two people disagreed about how things are supposed to be done. They failed to settle their individual or group grievances as brothers and instead resorted to using force. But the two groups have something in common. They are all Africans, sharing the same land, living on the same continent, and above all, do understand each other's language. You might call them Sudanese, I call them my brother. In Central African Republic, a generation of children is spoiled. Thousands have died, women raped and civilian men slaughtered. Children can't go to school, women give birth in shackles without proper medical attention, something that has claimed many lives. There is no stable government to lead growth and development of talent. Such African gifts and talents are lost, hoping tomorrow dismissed. The law of the jungle is working at its best. Hunger and preventable diseases have killed many, and hope for a better future is nothing but just dreams. More than 400,000 people have been internally displaced. According to the United Nations, that's nearly 10% of the population. Despite vast resources of the country, including diamonds, uranium, gold, and timber, Central African Republic is among the poorest nations of the world. You and I continue to ask the same question. Why are they fighting? Because of disagreement of two parties, who later turned their frustrations into religious wars. These people have one thing in common. They are all Africans, brothers killing each other in the name of fighting the enemy. What is so sad isn't the chaos, but a generation of young people who have mastered the art, not the art of success, but the art of slaughtering human beings. And the rest of us have now learned to live with this as something normal. In Libya, after the misfortunate death of what they referred to as the problem of Libya, then we all thought Libya would change and become a nation of peace, full of democracy. One that would allow young people there to realize their dreams and exploit their full potential. However, over 30,000 people lost their lives in such a tragedy. Thousands got lifelong illnesses and wounds. Thousands disintegrated. There are so thousands of children who will grow up without a mother, a father, or a brother or a sister. Men have gone back to square one trying to build a nation and a life from zero. Property worth billions of dollars was destroyed. Billions of dollars that would be used to enhance education, put medicine in hospitals, and construct roads to ease agriculture and trade was diverted in buying machines. What is sad, these machines are not one for agriculture or used in surgery, but once used for slaughtering human beings. Trauma is everywhere, and today each group thinks not of what investment to do, but how to protect itself from the other. The question pops up again, are these people brothers? Yes, they are all Africans who could sit down together and solve their issues in order to pave way for generations to come. In other nations of Africa that are not at war right now, we fear that the trend is the same. Why? There is a lot of corruption, and so resources are not used for their intended objectives. Those who are supposed to give direction to others are instead exploiting them, using them, and above all stealing from them. Greed and selfishness instead of filling up the veins of generosity. People power is still under the subjugation of military power. Individuals are becoming constitutions and constitutions becoming them. Hope and the future only put in the hands of the few and majority left to suffer. Children have nothing to hope in. And so many Africans are running away for new opportunities. Every year thousands die in the sea while trying to cross or to leave their home Africa for other nations. We hear of many put in prisons every day because of not possessing proper documents to live in other nations. Others are killed and hanged because of engaging in drug trafficking due to the frustrations of Africa. The African spirit is steadily dying out, and the young generation has learned a life of survival. In such a state of life, innovation, creativity, initiative cannot be at its best. And every day you wonder how the set millennium goals will be attained in such a state of confusion and survival, where people are running away from our challenges instead of facing them. For I do know that man must face his fate or be destroyed by it. Today, amid such frustrations and challenges, all we have done is keeping quiet and letting things happen. We might be doing something, yes, but we need to let our voices out. Africa must hear our voices. Our leaders and the world must know about our effort. They must hear our passions. For that is the only way we can influence what takes place in Africa and in the whole world. But instead of letting our voices out, there are many Africans who are citizens of other nations, who are citizens on other continents, who don't even think of Africa anymore. There are many today, if not running away, they are scheming for ways of running away or pleading to other people for visas to run away. There are thousands seated outside there, not concerned at all about what is taking place in Africa. But let me ask you, you're leaving your home for whom? Why are you running away? Why don't we stay and face these challenges together? Why can't we start from where we are with what we have now to change the situation? For I do understand that those other continents where you dream to be fought so much and sacrificed heavily every day for the peace and success you want to enjoy. Don't you think if we believe in the African dream, share it and begin to live it, we can do a lot to bring back hope to millions of hopeless? Don't you think you and I have the power to reverse this dark episode and ensure the brightness of our future's generation? Let me tell you, Africa needs us. Africa needs Africans. The generations to come require us to be stronger and to wait more. Our young brothers and sisters want to have a good example in their own lives. They need something to believe in and to focus on. They need us to hold their hands and hope to create a past for them. Let us not forget the creed of our foundation. I am because we are, and because we are, therefore I am. Let us agree to stand together, hold each other's hand tightly, and pledge to move forward like Moses did in Genesis. Let us use our gifts as our messengers to create a path of hope in this flowing river of hopelessness. In the end, I am your duty. You are my responsibility. We are each other's keeper. We need each other, for our strength, power, greatness, and success of tomorrow will be defined by our spirit of unity, the African spirit, and this is the African dream. And this is the African dream that I believe in. Let's affirm our faith in Africa. We are young Africans. We are world citizens too. We deserve to live, and our life is worth like any other persons around the world. We simply desire to live in a free society where our future isn't shaped by the nightmares of the day, but by the hopes and talents that do reside in each of us. We believe in the African dream as our gateway to the world dream. This is the power of SOF through which Africa is to change. If you do care about the future of Africa, share this message. If you're concerned about tomorrow, begin today and now. If you care that much about your neighbor who hasn't had a meal last night, share the little that you have. If you love your brother and sister, do something now and add your voice. If you think and believe in Africa, join me in this noble cause. If you believe in Africa, if you believe in the African dream, you can support by sharing this and making sure that your friends too can listen to this. Share this message with your friends, begin from where you are, the way you are, and with what you have. Let's come together and change Africa. It is my duty and your responsibility, which is our call. This is the African dream.